Welcome back. So, to all our loyal viewers and followers, you'll remember, probably better than I do, where I left off in this game. To recap, for those unfamiliar, or because it's been a while, this is Nancy Drew, The Deadly Device, in which one of the resident scientists of this laboratory that's in a mountainous research facility, a mountainous area, a very isolated facility, had passed away in the confines of the research facility. And so you've been hired on by Victor Lossett, one of the co-owners of this facility, to investigate what is presumed to be a murder, although you never know. It could be an accident, it could be something else. So it's fallen to you to figure out what happened. Victor Lossett, being one of the co-owners, would like to be able to sell this facility and sell the findings of these scientists. And so it's inconvenient for him that there's this ongoing police investigation that appears to be stalled. And so you get hired as the undercover detective that you are, as Nancy Drew, to go figure out what happened. Your character is... Okay, yeah, you do use the name Nancy. However, your role is supposed to be that of one of those interested in the facility just as a potential buyer. Not that you're buying, but you're helping research what happened in this facility and just make sure that everything's up to code and that this facility and the researchers meet your buyer's needs. So that's the guise you're under. And Victor Lossett, one of the co-owners, is A-OK with this kind of character and doesn't necessarily need to tell his staff all the details. And so there's some NDAs and such involved, such that you are able to go undercover and preserve this character. And the folks at the lab don't know exactly what your role is, other than they just suspect that you're there on behalf of an interested buyer who is remaining anonymous. So that said, the people who operate in this laboratory, I wonder if I have a character sheet. Let's see. I'm curious if I have a character sheet. Well, we're going to try loading this and see how we're doing here. So, we have a journal. It's interesting how we call everybody here a suspect. Yeah, your characters are Ellie, one of the researchers, Mason, another researcher, Dr. Gray. I'm drawing a blank, just connecting names and faces here. And hopefully I loaded the correct save, since we'll be able to progress fairly swiftly. Okay, so I'm sorry. No, Gray is just the administrator who keeps the lab together. I'm sorry, the security agent who does some duty as an administrator of the lab and just making sure that everything is done according to code. Ellie is a researcher who has greater aspirations but is interested in the working that they're doing at the research that they're doing at this facility. Mason is not a very personable character, but he's quite qualified at what he does. He's very meticulous and detail oriented. He likes to have all his pencils lined up on his desk perfectly. He likes to have all his journals aligned orthogonally to each other. And he's very OCD like that. Ryan is an engineer who does work as a mechanic at this facility in constructing the devices that they need constructed. She constructed a part that she later disassembled that was a piece of what happened on that night that the victim died. And she made some notes that were really cute and at the same time pretty threatening. Deirdre is one of Nancy's friends, in a sense, that is able to. She's doing an internship with criminal investigation. Not necessarily, but she's doing some internship inside public office, and she's able to provide some criminal research on our behalf so that we don't have to contact the police directly. So that's pretty useful. So she's able to provide us information such like the medical examiner's report says that Ellie waited half an hour before calling for help. A number was taken, so we wrote this number down that we found inside a book that was on Ellie's desk, Ellie being a researcher. Ryan would never or should never have been released is something that we found written down in a journal. We're curious what this number references, but something about this particular information or person or something should not have been released. Gray's the head of security, and we could always look inside his office if we're curious to learn some more about what was going on. And we determined that Ryan did have an alibi for the night of the murder, but the police are still suspecting Ryan anyway, so we're not sure. Just general observations, are things we found all over the lab, all over the facility. We found some stickers that all have letters on them. We found a blank key card, which we might want to program at some point. Gray had shredded a document that had mentioned some possible military applications of the research that's been done here. Nico mentioned receiving written threats from Ryan. Ryan will fix the broken media card player in Nico's office if I can bring Ryan some Cocoa Mallows. It's interesting. I don't know if I actually remember to fulfill that objective. Maybe I should. That sounds like something pretty trivial and straightforward. I heard a strange hum just outside the lab. That was quite a while ago, but the video number was found in the trash on Mason's computer. Oh, why did that scroll so quickly? Can I control this a little bit better, maybe? Ellie will let me snoop in Mason's office if I can beat Mason's high score. Basically, what this is saying is that Mason is really addicted to this game called aggregation, and that Ellie doesn't so much mind if I'm snooping in Mason's office while Mason tries to go beat the high score again. During Ellie's demo of the Tesla coil, I was managed to be kept safe in a Faraday cage. This might be important to remember that if I ever find my way back into the lab itself. Okay, I've been calling this facility and the lab synonymously, but they're really not. The lab is just the experiment area of this facility. It truly is a laboratory where they have some really high power machinery, including one extremely powerful Tesla coil that you don't want to mess with. And that perhaps killed the victim. We're not entirely sure. Everything, apparently the video doesn't seem to suggest what happened. Everyone wants me to stay out of the lab, but, you know, without access to the scene of the crime, it's really difficult to figure out what happened. The binary chart in the hall could come in handy at some point. Gray, the head of security, mentioned the lab could go critical under the right circumstances, which sounds pretty bad. A security video referenced in the case file is that security number. Ellie and Gray are on the night crew, whereas Ryan and Mason are available during the day. Basically, the story behind that, I think, is just that Ryan. No. No. What was the deal? Maybe it was Ellie and Mason who didn't get along. There's some combination of these folks. Maybe it was Gray and Mason who just didn't get along, and that's why they work opposite shifts. Either way, it seems to work pretty well for everybody. They grudgingly get along. They're not the most social of folks. That's okay. They're all research scientists. As long as nothing negative happens, like what actually happened, then the fact that there's a little bit of animosity isn't really the biggest concern in the world. Case file in Nico's office has a summary of all the information, so that was one of the first observations we made. After the observation of I being hired by Victor Lozet to investigate the cold case murder, oh, yes, a prominent scientist, Niko Jovic. So the police were unable to solve the case, or their investigation is pending. Still looking into it, but they're quite frustrated at this point. And they are holding all of Nico's research and evidence, which makes it hard for Victor to sell Nico's research. So Victor hopes to help the police and help us crack the case by sending in me undercover. So that's the synopsis of what's going on. That's our journal. We've got a task list saying things for us to do. You can, if you're ever stuck, click on the question marks to get clues, but I've been avoiding doing so where I'm able to figure things out without getting very frustrated with the game. In one case, I did end up saying, just give me the answer, because I didn't feel like going around the lab hunting down tons of little stickers. But that aside, yeah, I've been solving these pretty well. So feel free to participate, suggest hints, advice, whatnot. Although I think at this point I might be streaming at too high of a bit rate for most viewers to keep up, so for that I apologize. I would blame Twitch if I could. But anyhow. Let's see. Use the key card to. Okay, let's start at the top. Figure out what the extra data showing in the video with Gray means. Didn't we do this? No, I thought. Okay, maybe we haven't. Use the key card to get past the locked door. I'm working on that. Figure out why Mason was in the lab after hours. Yep, I thought so. Explore the lab.
Can't check that off yet.
Yeah, without a key card, I don't think we can do that. Snoop the security booth.
Check.
Oh, okay. I did not know that we achieved that. Let's see, what was snooping the security booth? I'm trying to recall what that entailed. Oh, that was me looking through the head of security, in Gray's office. I think at one point Ellie even guided us to some other room, but. Okay, we can look at our inventory. We've got some cat parts. We've got some more cat parts. I think there is a cat part in the photolithography lab, so I haven't been able to go to Nancy. No, not to Nancy, to Ellie, or to Ryan, rather, to reconstruct said cat. So let's go say hi to everybody one more time, just in case you've forgotten who some of these nice people are. Given how well illuminated the lab is, this surely must be the daytime. This is a really nice piece of artwork in the middle of the facility, too. Oh, you can actually see it from here. I've been having difficulty finding a perspective that shows that artwork off. But no, that looks pretty cool. You can't open this door, so that must be a maintenance closet or something. Let's see. Right, so this is daytime. So here's Mason. You see, like, he's got his binders lined up very, I don't know. He's a very organized fellow. He's very meticulous about the way he does
I'll let you
things.
go.
It's unfortunate that he's not the, I don't know, not the most personable person, but he's quite cordial. So we've already discovered everything that's discoverable in that area, as far as I know. So Mason's one of the people that works during the day. The other is Ryan. You can see Ryan works in a very different sort of context. This area's not. Yeah. This is Ryan's area, basically, is what we're saying. Hey, look. Stuff. Security office, do not remove. Okay, it's not going to let me take some of this mechanic stuff, which admittedly all is Ryan's, so why should I be taking it? I think we've explored all these things up here. Is there anything else up there? No. No, okay, so I can't click anything over here. Let's say hi to Ryan. It's been a while. Apparently, we don't have any more dialogue to discuss, so. Bye! Yeah, she's a pretty nice person. Yeah, she's very handy with tools and assembling things. So it's good for a research facility to have a competent mechanic. I've got all these cat parts, but it's not quite enough to assemble the entire cat. So I think there was a cat part in the photolithography lab. But my one experience in there was, well, let's just say it was quite the experience. Nancy only died like two or three times in that lab, so. So we've seen the upper floor. We could see the lower floor. This office is locked during the day. That's the office of Gray, the head of security. Here's Nico's office. Nico's a pretty prominent researcher. This cute little bird here. See. Oh, there was a code to get into here. Let's see, I've got the code somewhere. Where's the code? I'm not seeing the code. Oh, 171943. So, yeah, here's Victor's notes for me. Keep the contents of this file to myself. I'll be busted if anybody discovers that I have this. Again, this just reminds us of who the characters are. Nico's the research scientist. Oh, he's a co-owner of technology at Tomorrow Today facility, which that must be this facility. He's a genius in the field, known to have poor social skills, perceived as unfriendly or uncaring, even antagonistic by coworkers. His expertise and decades of experience and high safety features built into the Tesla coil's operating procedures indicate against this being a workplace accident. And therefore, we think that this is suspicious. We think something happened because, Nico is pretty competent, and there's all kinds of safety measures. Personnel, these lab access is restricted only to those who have secure key card entry to the lab. There's Mason, who we met upstairs, claims to have been on a date at the time of death, but according to his date, they parted ways by 10:30. Dislike of the victim is evident during questioning. Ellie York, we will meet over the night shift on site at the time of death. Called 911 to report incident. Left town the following evening. Ryan Kilpatrick is a technical engineer, day shift. She's the one who assembles the machines here. Stated that she was driving back to the lab from Colorado Springs at the time of death. Appeared distraught, evasive, and nervous during questioning. Built the machine that killed the victim. Gray Courtright had a security night shift on site at the time of death. Taciturn, recalcitrant, and unfriendly toward police. Refused to speak of his relationship with the victim. Co-workers seemed uncertain as how he's managed to keep this position. And there's Victor Lozett, who hired us to help investigate the case. Laboratory co-owner, along with Nico, who has an off-site office, oversees business and financial decisions, stated that he was working alone in off-site office at time of death. Suspect questioning failed to provide an ironclad alibi for any employee. Key card log record suggests another entry shortly before victim's death. But security video obtained from the head of security showed no one entering the lab from the time of victim's entrance until after his time of death. The key card used to enter the lab after the victim has not been recovered from premises and does not match any key card ID in the logs. It's believed a power surge that occurred on site as a result of the coil tests being run shortly before the victim's death, causing a glitch in the log system. Witness statements and crime scene evidence suggest Ryan as the prime suspect. She was arrested and brought to the police for interrogation. After lengthy questioning, she was released due to lack of concrete evidence, but she remains a person of interest. No further leads at this time. The case remains open and unsolved. Crime scene decontaminated and labs, office, and surrounding rooms restored to pre-incident state. Personal belongings of the victim have been recovered as evidence, including files and experiment notes, and they will remain in police possession for further investigation. But the actual scientific equipment has been returned to the lab, and the site reopened for research to continue. Okay. So, that's our premise. I can't click any of these other books. I can't close the drawer this way, apparently. There's something on the other side of the desk. Let's take a look. Let's take a look over here if we can. Okay, I can't get into this corner. I can't look at what was on Nico's desk necessarily, but whatever. Without a key, obviously I can't get that open. That's a shame that this is just decor as opposed to something I can investigate. But yeah, Nico has quite a nice office. Here is our candy machine. So I forget if I've already satisfied Ryan's craving for candy. Ryan will fix the broken media card player in Nico's office if I bring her some Cocoa Mallows. I thought I had done this. Pretty sure I have. If not, I can always come back to do some more memory games. Okay. Before we go there, let me just comment on the one remaining aspect of the lab, if I can see it. So there's the main laboratory. Somewhere, yeah, apparently I can't see it, but there's a photolithography lab we have seen before. Also, big red button. You have to push the big red button. I mean, how could you not push the button? It's just begging to be pushed. Okay. This is a nice piece of furniture in the corner. It's like a bookshelf that snakes and weaves both directions. Wait, what was this? Out of order microwave. You would think that they would fix that. Like, this being a place where people live and all, you'd think that they'd fix some of these things. Prevent office supplies kidnappings. Do not move the tape. So all these things to assemble papers with. There's a picture. Do you recognize this fellow? You probably should. Yeah, it's Nikola Tesla. Here's the aggregation game that Mason is so addicted to, and that we keep beating Mason's high score. Oh, what's that in the corner? That looks like a DNA, or a double helix in any way. Here's a stress reduction tool. You've probably seen one of these before. But in order to reduce stress, you apply this to a hard surface and then bang your head against it, and that will reduce stress. There's a washroom, and then there's our sleeping quarter. And yeah, you can learn more about the life and times of Nikola Tesla if you're not familiar. So, that's what's going on here. Last we left off, I had gotten stuck on one of the mini games, and so let's go back to that mini game. Sorry for the wandering digression, by the way, but I just felt it need necessary to cover all these steps. So last time I got stuck on something that I think is quite challenging. You might disagree. Running footsteps are heard in the background. So our head of security has left his desk, giving us an opportunity to try. Oops, we don't need that. Unknown. Okay, hang on. So we can put this into the machine. Can read the key card, and then we need to be able to write a card. So we've read this card. That's our unknown card, and then we have to put our blank card in there. And then create a card. So the key to this puzzle is solving it counterclockwise or anti-clockwise. I'd seen from another person solving this. Now, we do have a limited amount of time before the head of security comes back, so it does behoove us to try to solve this fairly rapidly. So that's hidden behind this, if I'm seeing that correctly. There's a blue square here. A red square overlay at the top of it. I think there's a yellow rectangle in the lower right. It's occluded by these two. So let's put the. Oh no. So that goes here. This goes here. This, I think, goes here. We're going to need this in the upper right. Something like this? Or is it like that? This is challenging. This is on top. This is on top, but the red square is on top of all of that. Yeah, if anybody happens to know how to do this, that would actually help substantially. Okay, let's get out of here. If I can find my way out. I'm not optimistic at all. Like, I would think that Nancy would tell me if I've solved this correctly. So we've got a key card, we wrote to the key card. Surprisingly, nobody at the lab has questioned what's been going on here. Yeah, okay. So I've been attempting to forge a card and struggling quite badly at it. And apparently I'm going to continue struggling at that. I'm not sure what else I can do. It's just a really challenging minigame. It's kind of unforgiving. So let's take a minute. Appreciate that this is something that we had found in Gray's office. Just a diagram for a machine. It's got some notes on here. Probably Nico's writing, if I had to guess. Probably Nico asked Ryan to assemble or help assemble such a thing. But I'm not sure. So we're going to attempt again to assemble or to create, to fabricate a card. And hopefully if I'm successful at fabricating a card, then we can progress on and play the remainder of the game here and not spend all day fabricating cards. If not, if I struggle so badly with this that I can't manage to do it online, I might have to do it off stream, which would be sad, but maybe that's what I've got to do. Card. This in there. Let's reset this once more. Let's put this in place. Put this in place. I think this goes down here. I'm a bit fuzzy where everything else goes. We've got this orange thing, but that seems to be underneath the purple thing. So let's bury that. Let's see, then we got this green thing, which maybe gets buried underneath this purple square. But there's a yellow rectangle involved in all of this. So maybe it's stacked like that. Where does this go? Okay, but that, if that's vertically oriented, actually, does that go up here? I'm not sure. And then we've got, where's this green one go? Up here somewhere, right? Does this blue go down there? It's really difficult to ascertain what's going on here. Right click to rotate. That doesn't help. Maybe this goes like that. Okay, this blue goes on top. And then red goes on top of all of this. And then we send that. I'm pretty sure I got it wrong again. But what can you do? Either way, let's try this again. Perhaps some of you watching, I don't know, take some amusement in this. I hit the wrong button. There's no way I'm going into the lab with the head of security present. That wouldn't make any sense. So let's wait until morning. That's what I meant to do. Okay. Can we access the lab now? I don't think so. It's locked. Nope. Yeah, so no such luck. Nancy usually tells me when I've done something right. I don't really get that sense with my attempts at the key card manufacturing device. So I'm just gonna have to keep trying permutations until I hit on the right one. Which, unfortunately, there's a very limited time window for each time I attempt to use that machine. Because I have to lure Gray out of his office in order to be able to use it. So now Gray's out of his office. I'm able to use Gray's desk without detection. So let's reset this again. This time, attempt putting these larger blocks in place first. Yellow block's gonna go up here. This yellow block's gonna go there. There's a blue block up here, or I'm sorry, a purple block, and a green one. I'm not sure if the ordering of these tiles on top of each other is significant or not. Okay, got the that in the corner. This here might be onto something. I don't know. That doesn't look right. So let's take the blue off, put the blue back on top of this. And then do that. Maybe I just need to watch a video of somebody doing that correctly. Because I'm struggling quite a bit with that. I'm not liking the fact that Nancy is not saying, "Yes, I solved it." I mean, when I look at the key combination I'm producing looks very similar to the diagram I'm copying from. Yeah, it's not good enough. Well, let's take a journey up to the mechanics room again. Was that a key card reader? Is what Ryan called that device? Is that something I'm able to use here? This thing. Apparently not. So the other observation in my observation set was that if I manage to win a game of memory and collect some Coco Mallows, Ryan would help me out a bit. But I thought I've already done that. But this could be a useful diversion in any event. So let's do it. Green. Green, orange. Green, orange, pink. Four, three. 3, 2, 4, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, 1, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, 1, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, 1, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, 1, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, 1, 1, 4, 2. All right. Yeah, I thought I'd already picked up the Coco Mallows out of here. Let's see, could I benefit from taking any of these? Which one do you guys want me to take? I'll ask that while I'm gonna get a brief snack over here. Pick wisely, if anybody's watching. Let me refresh my chat window in case somebody does say hi. Looks like it falls to me to make a selection then. Sure, why not? Why can't I just take all the candies all at once? I suppose that would be too easy. Oh, maybe I should say hi to Ryan while I'm holding candy. It wouldn't hurt. See. Oh, you don't want my candy. Can I not offer? You want this? Bye.
Bye. Later.
All right, can I assemble the cat?
I'm still missing parts. I need to find them
Oh,
first.
come on. Don't be like that. Help me out. I want to see even a partial cat. I want to see what I'm missing. Fine. Okay, I've got to go find the parts. Oh, can I hit the button now? Okay, yeah, but it closes the door. Or I close the door. I have the sensibility to seal the door while I am descending so as not to, like, stick my finger out and break it. Which is okay. All right, let's keep messing with Gray's machine until we get caught again. Say that because I've messed with that machine so many times and it's so little success. That one time I had even just stuck it out, just kept pushing buttons on the machine, and eventually Gray caught me. Though it takes a while. Like I said, you have a limited time here. But that's not to suggest that time is the major constraint. Let's try this. Stick the little thing here in the corner. Big purple rectangle on top. Blue atop that. Then we stick our green over here, maybe? Or is it like this? I still think it's like that. Because that creates this darker color back there. But yellow is buried underneath green, and green is buried underneath purple. I still see an orange color here, which confuses me. I thought, surely we're sticking our orange tile underneath there, right? Not sticking that here, are we? I mean, that'd be something I haven't tried yet, but... but what would that make this in the corner? Surely this is not a green tile in the corner. It has much more of a reddish hue to it. So that's why I keep suggesting putting this here. I mean, that looks right. Also looks right that we put this here. And then this goes somewhere around here. This underneath it. Like, this has got to be like that somehow. Maybe this goes like that, vertically. Does this create the correct color there? Wait. Then we stick purple on top. This is the wrong color of purple. And that's the wrong color of green. So this has to be buried underneath there somehow. Which further suggests this is like down here. Well, maybe that's where that orange color comes from. Still, where does our purple here come from? Is it like this? This is on top. And I still have my blue sliver, something like this, maybe? That's not quite right. Where am I mistaken? Yellow on top. Yellow's also on top here, but green is on top of yellow, purple's on top of green. Still doesn't look right, but let's send it. You know, through enough permutations, we will eventually get it. It's just that might take a while. So buckle up for the long haul or help me out. It's unfortunate I can't, like, simulate that offline. Like, the only place I can attempt to do something similar to that is in that very office. Yes, I need a key card to get in. Oh, this scrolls through my inventory. Yeah, that doesn't work. That card's disabled, or just... I don't know. So, we're gonna keep trying this, guys. We will get this. It's amazing how much the other occupants of this facility are willing to put up with me being here. 10 months later, I'm still hitting the button. And nobody suspects a thing. I mean, each one of those could be a legitimate security concern, so Gray does need to tend to that. But you would think after a while somebody might catch on. So let's reset this again. Try orange in the corner, purple atop that, blue on top of purple. It's going to be the square. This yellow rectangle over here. green, horizontally, vertically, something, maybe vertically. That doesn't look like the right color, so this must be horizontal. Oh, but green's on top. And then we've got a purple square down here. Got blue up there. Is this vertical or horizontal? Like, if I stick the red square on top of this, that's not producing the right color. So maybe we try horizontal. Does this produce the correct color down here? Yeah, that looks like the correct orangish color. Let's see, blue goes on top of that. Green goes somewhere in here that I can't really pinpoint where. Stick this like that. Okay. I'm actually getting excited here. This looks okay. No, yellow on top. This is quite exciting. Yellow on top. Yeah, it looks very close. Somebody's gonna have to tell me afterward how I messed that up. I really just don't like the idea of being discovered here. So that's part of what's frustrating me this whole time. I'm sure it'd be more effective if I could just sit there and not worry about the potential of being discovered again and having to deal with all that. I know it's just a game, too. But the music is really tense. Like, really seriously tense. All right, so I missed it yet again. We're gonna try this again. We're gonna just keep going until we get it. Each time, hopefully, I'll be a little bit closer. And you know, if somehow I just can't get it, we'll burn that bridge when we come to it. But let's say hi to Gray. What's
Yeah,
up?
what?
Oh, you seem cheerful.
Goodbye.
Okay, cool. He can't be too happy about my prolonged residence here. Though it's not his choice, so what does he care? Honestly, Ryan's probably the one most likely to get upset at my extended presence, because I'm probably eating all of the food that she wants to eat. So let's try that card. Key cards. So yeah, seriously, how did I miss this? What looks different? Oh, my blue's not on top of my red. Let's unbury this blue. Now if I put the red back in place and I put the blue on top, that's not quite right either. Okay, now the yellow on top of the red. That's not correct. Why is this wrong? This very much looks correct. Seriously, Nancy usually tells me, got it when you get it, but I'm not seeing it. So each time I'm being optimistic that I did it right, but optimism itself is not enough to solve these puzzles. You actually have to get the correct solution. It'd be also nice if the game could just like take pity on me eventually. Like, I don't know if you've ever played Chip's Challenge, but after enough failed attempts of a level, it asks you, would you like to just continue on and pretend like or just skip this level. And you can always come back to it later. Oh, look at me, I'm all ready to hit the button again. You know, this changing of day to night and night to day perhaps is unnecessary, because perhaps you can go into the lab while Gray is there. I would not advise doing so, but maybe the game lets you do it. I haven't tried. Hey, look, I found a more efficient way to get to the button. So there's that. So, seriously, how is this not good enough? What am I missing? This looks identical. Let me get a closer look at the screen. Like, does this little rectangle in the lower right need to be on top of everything? Is that what I'm messing up? This very much looks like the correct solution. Couldn't possibly be this, could it? So blue's got to go on top there, so we have to put the purple there. Then maybe put this on top, and maybe put this here. And then red has to go on top of that, and yellow on top. I mean, that looks correct. Everything I do looks correct, but only one thing is actually correct. I need to watch a video of this. This is what this is coming down to. But I'm stubborn. I shan't give in to the temptation of cheating. Where would our adventure be if I didn't have to solve these puzzles on my own? Oh my god. It was that freaking orange rectangle. Okay. Well, this is cool. Hey, look, we got access to a high power lab. There's stuff everywhere here, though. Oh wow. I can actually see everything in the lab. That's pretty cool. That freaking orange rectangle. Alright, so I'm not interested in going into the security booth. Yeah, that's the photolithography lab that I'm looking for. Here, please let me go in. Because I've been here once before. That was the cat part that I was looking for. Thank goodness. I can do this while Gray is off-site, because he's not going to make a journey all the way from off-site to back on-site. I'm not going to go back up there. That was how I escaped here last time I accidentally ended up in here. But now that we're here, let's take a closer look. From dreams to reality, manufacturing design. Rapid prototyping machines. Should you ever need it and I'm not available, I loaded the program on the computer next to the Escher that designs a circuit. I presume you use this to print to a blank wafer, which has all these transistors on it and can etch the appropriate circuit. Etching process typically takes half a day to complete. So you get the etching solution tank, the image tray, the tray for the blank wafer, and the start button. So you have to pour the solution in. The image tray, you must be programming the computer to create the image. then insert the image into the image tray. So you add the etching solution into the etcher. Care must be taken to develop the correct developer solution. The incorrect solution will degrade the entire wafer. I wouldn't necessarily think that's the case, but whatever. I mean, if you just put water in there, that's not going to degrade the wafer, but other chemicals probably could. Next, the image to be transferred is loaded from the computer into the image tray, where it will be exposed to light against a wafer. After loading a blank wafer, press the start button. The etching process typically takes half a day to complete. So, can we get a look at the computer? Oh, do I even have a circuit that I want to etch? I don't think so. See, there's some high power chemicals here. Not stuff to be played with lightly. Oh, what happens if I hit the talk button?
Is there anyone there?
Yeah, that's unwise. I mean, given that I'm not supposed to be in here. Whoops. Yeah, I've got access to the lab now, so that's cool. Now I understand that game a little bit better. And so here's the high-power Tesla coil, which has a missing part. That missing part, which is disassembled, allegedly killed the victim. So proceed with caution, I suppose. Looks like a manhole of some sort. I'm not sure. So, yeah, we see here's a Faraday cage. Oh, I need to get the lightning rod working? Lightning rod. That's a fun, fancy name for a Tesla coil. A really high-powered... Oh! Oh, right, right. I had completely forgotten. It's been much too long. I do have the clues I need to figure this out. So what? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 to the power of 5, so you get 36, 216. 1,300 something, and then 7,000 something. So there's a lot of possible combinations. Not combinations, permutations, whatever. You know what I'm trying to say. There's a lot of ways you can punch in a password. Nancy says, I do have the clues I need to solve this. It's been entirely too long since I've reviewed said clues, however, so let's go back through my inventory and see what we've got. We've got evidence. Unless you're dying to see the inside of a body bag, I suggest you rethink your plans. Oh, the gummies make it look so innocent. Keep out of the lab, stay out of my lab. It is Nico's lab, and Gray's just the security agent. Gray's saying, I have work to do in the lab. You propose I abandon that work. Yeah. We got some something or other there. Got Tesla coils, a user's guide. I don't think I had anything about colors or symbols here. Got some capacitors. Oh, here we are. Hints to this month's passcode for the control booth. The red shape is pressed neither first nor last. The green shape is pressed immediately after the diamond. The yellow shape is pressed last. The blue shape is a star. The purple shape is not first. The square isn't red. The purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. The triangle is pressed second. oh, so I have to get the correct colors, and then I have to press the shapes in the right order. All right. So, wow. Okay, the blue shape is a star. That's a clue. Okay, next clue. Square is not red. The purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. Triangle is pressed second. Circle is pressed before the yellow shape. Okay. The green shape is not the diamond. Square is not red. Blue shape is a star. Let me just randomly pick some colors. So square is not red. Green shape's not the diamond. So, does this contradict anything that's there? The purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. The triangle is pressed second. The circle is pressed before the yellow shape. Circles. Okay, let's just try this. Honestly, guess and check is easier than deduction here. The red shape is neither first nor last. The circle is pressed before the yellow shape. So the diamond is not the yellow shape because the circle... Well, no. I don't know if that's saying the circle is pressed immediately prior to the yellow shape or whatever, but the yellow shape is pressed last. I mean, this is consistent. So the triangle could be last. Purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. So square, diamond, circle, triangle. Square, diamond, circle, triangle. I guess that would make the star first, right? Purple shape, diamond, and circle are pressed in order. Apparently that's incorrect. Alright. What else would be sensible? I could make the triangle purple. I could make the square yellow. I think that's really the only other combination I could try, I think. Purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. The blue shape's a star. The yellow shape is last. So either the circle's yellow. Oh, the triangle's pressed second. Never mind. Let's try making the circle yellow. The circle's gonna be yellow. This needs to be some other color. The purple shape, the diamond, and the circle are pressed in order. Oh, and the triangle's pressed second. And which one's last? Yellow shape is last. So yeah, this is actually fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that not gaining me access? That is not gaining me access. Okay, the yellow shape is last. Let's try making all these yellow. Yellow, 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 yellow. Although we know that the star is blue. Square is not red. Purple, diamond, and circle are pressed in order. The triangle is second. The circle is pressed before the yellow shape. So if we make the, wait. Triangle is second. If the triangle is second, but the circle is pressed before the yellow shape, the triangle cannot be yellow. Triangle's got to be some other color. Yellow shape is last. let's make the triangle first. Let's just say that it's red. But no, if we can't make that red and first, right? Because the red shape is neither first nor last. So what color can we make the triangle? Purple shape, diamond, and circle are pressed in order. So yeah, maybe the triangle does have to be purple. It's pressed second. The circle is pressed before the yellow shape. Purple, diamond, circle, yellow. So which one am I going to make yellow? The square? Let's pick some colors for these two. One of these got to be red, one's got to be green. Oh, but the yellow one's last. Doesn't matter which. Red one's neither first nor last. Green is after the diamond. So let's make the circle green. Make this red. And then push these in order, right? Purple, diamond, circle are pressed in order. Purple, diamond, circle. Purple, diamond, circle, yellow. That wasn't so hard. Guess and check was far easier than bringing out the truth table. You want to be really careful with this. But yeah, you can use this to control. I'm not sure why Nancy even wants to engage that device, other than to see how it works. Ellie's notes on Tesla coil safety. Choose a level, power on. Oh my goodness. Wow. Such technical writing ability. It just speaks volumes. Like, seriously. Okay, well, I guess there's not much more to it, but my goodness. This is the worst technical writing I have ever seen. And it's regarding a very dangerous device, so. Okay, choose the level, power it on, charge the power, and engage the system. Follow safety measures during tests. Do not exit the control booth while tests are in progress. If you're on the floor, stay in the Faraday cage. My goodness, you should not be here if this is in progress. I guess the only reason they have this kind of functionality is so you can observe things while they're ongoing. But my goodness, wouldn't you just want to put a camera there? I guess maybe if there's something you don't want observed on camera, maybe you want to do it in person, but that's terrible. You don't want to do that. Use caution when exiting booth while low-level tests are in progress. Always discharge capacitors before working on the coil. Oh my goodness. I want to tear Ellie a new one for this particular style of writing. Oh, okay. There's more here. Safety systems reintegrated and confirmed working. Restarting testing tomorrow. Occasional surges observed. Source unknown. Testing on hold. Cause of technical difficulty still diagnosed, but gave required coil demonstration per Victor's demand. Some discrepancies in power levels still observed when I came back to get rid of the annoying assistant. Parts were missing from the coil. Have to track them down again. So this must be Ellie's writing. Because we saw Ellie's writing on the rest of this. Victor required that Ellie give a demonstration, even though there are some technical difficulties. Such is the life of a researcher, where you're forced to produce results in order to make a living. And the research facility needs to produce results too. They can't just experiment all day. When I came back after getting rid of that annoying assistant, parts were missing from the coil. Yeah, I mean, what can you do? Is the game really asking me to demonstrate this coil in action just to see if it works or not? Okay. Initial power. Charge. Engage.
Wait, why isn't it working?
What are you doing?
Oh, shit. Oops.
Coil is deadly. Mess with that again, I'll be the least of your worries. Get out.
Oh. Okay. Well, that's no good.
What were you doing in the lab?
I had a hunch I needed to follow up on.
Okay. Well, huh. That's no good. Wow. I mean, that asks so many questions. But I thought part of my checklist was that I needed, for some reason, to do that. It's absolutely something I should not be doing, but did this journal not, I'm sorry, did my task list not ask me to do that?
Jack? Jack? Still have to do that.
Still have to explore the lab. We got,
did that.
Got past the locked door.
That's done.
Explore the photolithography lab. Repair the Tesla coil.
Let's see.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought those are still in progress.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
Let's say hi to Ellie. It's been a while since we've said hi to Ellie. I keep getting turned around in this office. Oh yeah, let's say hi to Ryan too. Can I assemble this cat?
I'm still missing parts. I need to find them first.
What parts could I possibly be missing? Okay. So apparently I do need to repair the Tesla coil. Absolutely cannot do that while Gray is present. So let's delay for a day, wait for Gray to leave, and then trespass again, because that's what we're good at. Can I save the game? Let's see. Lab. Save. Yeah, obviously people... Yeah, obviously the owner and Gray are both extremely ticked that I got access. So I'm surprised it's expected of me to repair the Tesla coil. Let's see, what are we looking at here? There's a lot of parts in this lab. Okay, I mean, there's the wafers here. I could take... I've already got a wafer. Pretty sure I'm not allowed to mess with the chemicals in the... in this booth. Though I would need to prepare a solution if I'm going to make a wafer. Yeah, I can understand why people definitely do not want Nancy or anybody who's not insured in the lab. Lab is not a place for just random strangers. Oh. So Ryan's got a note in the book. I have a sense that I'm going to get kicked out again. So where's Ryan's note in this book? I'm not seeing a note. That's not it. That's not it. Wow, that's quite a few notes there. I'm not seeing anything. I'm so gonna get kicked out of this lab. But what can I do? I mean, how could I possibly assemble this circuit? I mean, if I assemble this wrong, the game could kill me. So it's pretty important that I not just screw around with it. But like, what kind of note do you think this is? Seriously. Let's head out. Yeah, absolutely, I should not be there. There's the photolithography lab. Let's head out and see Ryan again. And perhaps this will help me out with just, I don't know. I'm not even sure at this point.
What's up?
Oh.
Goodbye. Later.
Some capacitors here. Oh, can we assemble this now? Nice. Cat head. Cat tail. Nice. 5 parts. We've got a working cat. Aww. Jeez, that's really advanced stuff. Okay. Well, that was important. Alright.
Hi. I better get going. Later.
You're not even gonna say anything about this cat that I endeavored so with so much difficulty to assemble this, and it's just for show. Oh well. Okay, so we got the box of capacitors, but how do we solve the capacitor challenge? I'm not going to be able to solve this during the day, am I? Wait, do I have a picture on my phone of what I need to do? Where's my pictures? View photos. Yeah, we got some interesting photos here. Oh, I forgot this note, so I don't need that photo. Yeah, perhaps more things than I should have. So let's go back to the menu. Colorado Springs, Colorado. I have a feeling I might need another chance to look at a book or something. What was the clue provided that when I was trying to assemble the circuit? In fact, let me save my game again before I do something too dumb. Right, in we go. And to the most dangerous part we go. You gave me a clue on this, which is that this matches something. Well, I guess I'm just gonna have to randomly guess where to put the resistors. Either that or I need to figure this stuff out. Let's just say that if we've got enough in a column that it's okay. Even though that really doesn't make any sense. Oh, can I flip these? Yeah, there we go. Oh, I was so worried about doing this incorrectly. Now I just have a 50-50 chance of it being completely wrong. Oh, this has got to be like that. Nope. Oh, this one's upside down. Okay. Is this good enough?
Can't check that off yet.
How is this not good enough? Is this completely upside down? What? Can I start this over? Right click to rotate. Start the red one on top. Yeah, that gives. I somehow have the illusion that this is right side up. Okay, now that's not that's not correct either. Apparently. I can't just slide this back in. No.
That must be where the switch goes.
Switch. That's not a switch. So yeah, I'm confused. Is there some kind of indicator as to how to assemble this somewhere in the circuit? I mean, as far as I can see, these are all equivalent. Maybe there's some subtle nuance somewhere here, but I'm not seeing it.
Hmm.
So, I think, yeah, something in. So Nancy mentioned Ryan's lab, but that doesn't sound correct. Like, of anywhere that I would have expected to find a schematic, Ryan's lab, Ryan's machine lab here would be the last place I'd expect something. So I'm not sure what else to look for here. Unfortunately, I can't inquire for Ryan's help, as I'm doing kind of sensitive work at the moment. And really, I shouldn't be in the lab. I think I've already, last session, forever ago, talked with everybody. And done all the snooping that I could possibly snoop. Read all the books that I could possibly read. So perhaps it's time to say hi to Ellie again. Okay. To say hi to Ellie. We could read. There's this device reader here. It's got Nico's diary. Huh. Wow, that's strong. Okay. That's worthy of note. All right, so Freddy said hi to everybody. Yes, let's say hi to Ellie, rather. I have not said hi to Ellie. And we've already explored this room, and there's nothing worth reading here that the game allows us access to. So, yeah. On to nighttime. I think I just had a sequence break, when the game suggested that I've seen something on Ryan's computer, or I'm not sure if I heard Ryan, if I misheard a name. Because there's no way that that information could possibly be in the machine lab. Yeah, Ellie's workspace is it's quite, I don't know, the opposite of Mason's workspace. Whoops. Oops. No, can I put the book down? I know it's a great book and all. No, that's not what I wanted. Got some computer code, some more computer code. Yeah. It's all good fun. It's a nice little picture. Is there anything else worth exploring in this section of the world?
Strange. What's Ellie up to with this?
Curl up some good books. Condemned elephant's name. V equals IR. Tesla's good friend. Element A 74. Incorrect radio patent holder. 1893 Columbian Expo site. Sagra Morris Fellow Knight.
Can't check that off yet.
Yeah, that looks really confusing. Like, you thought other things were confusing. There's no figuring that one out. Well, Sagra Morris Fellow Knight. Connecticut Yankee in King Arthur's court. His visor was up. There was death in his smile. I should never be able to dodge his sword. That was plain. Someone was going to die this time. If he got the drop on me, I could name the corpse. We rode forward together and saluted the royalties. This time, the king was disturbed. He said, "Where is thy strange weapon?" "It is stolen, sire." "Hast another at hand?" "No, sire. I brought only the one." "Then Merlin mixed in." "He brought but the one, because there was but the one to bring. There exists none other than the one. It belongeth to the king of the demons of the sea. This man's a pretender and ignorant. Else he had known that that weapon could only be used in 8 bouts only, and then vanquished the way to its home under the sea." "Then he is weaponless." "Ah," said the king. "Sir Sagamore, you will grant him leave to borrow." "And I will lend," said Sir Lancelot, limping up. "He is brave a knight as hands as any be then live, and he shall have mine." Then put his sword to draw it, but Sir Sagamore said, "Stay, as it may not be. He shall fight with his own weapons. It was his privilege to choose them and bring them. If he has erred, on his head be it." "Knight," said the king, "thou art overwrought with passion. It disorders thy mind. Wouldst thou kill a naked man?" So it sounds like Lancelot. "And you shall do it. He'll answer to me," said Lancelot. So, let's see. How did that conflict go, I wonder? So, yeah, Sagamore saying, "None of this. I'm going to fight this fight. You don't give him a weapon." So the king allows them to fight, even though one of them has no weapon. That's quite sad.
Can't check that off yet.
V equals IR is the voltage formula. So the last of these is Lancelot. I don't know if the patent holder would be Edison or Marconi or what. Element 74. Just going to put a guess out there that's uranium, but that's probably wrong. No, uranium's like 94. Yeah, I don't know. That's a really weird list. That's a cool photo. Is there anything more to observe here? I think we've observed everything. So V equals IR is the voltage formula. Wheeler's formula for secondary coil calculations for the inductance in microhenries. It's equals to the radius squared n squared over 9r plus 10h. Yeah. So, oh wow. That's funny, changing these 16s to 15s and the 7.5 to an 8. And like, real scientists don't deal with numbers over 8 very often. I don't know. Maybe they do. But real mathematicians deal with formulas and such. And a lot of science is expressed in terms of multivariable calculus and stuff. So we've got a design application, a record repository. I can't view each one of these now. They're just a summary. Single item in the trash bin. Component craze. Yeah, let's do this. It's been a while. Ready? Resistor, diode, fuse, speaker, transistor, battery, inductor, battery, transistor, integrated circuit, battery, battery, resistor, resistor, capacitor, transistor, capacitor, capacitor, integrated circuit. Nope. Is this the diode? That's a fuse. That's a diode, that's a diode, that's a transistor, that's a transistor, it's a fuse, it's an IC, that's a switch, speaker, an inductor. There we go. A respectable score, though we could do better. Supercharged. Try again. Alright, here we go. Component craze. Take two, action. Switch capacitor, transistor, speaker, battery, IC, capacitor, resistor, capacitor, capacitor, inductor, fuse, batteries, somewhere up here, speaker, diode, transistor, speaker. You can tell that my attention span has gone just to the wayside. Inductor? Yeah. Switch? Nope, that's not the switch. It's diode. Fuse. Transistor. Switch is up here. Diode is that. That. Battery. Fuse. Battery. Fuse. Diode. Fuse. Fuse. Transistor. There we go. Under a minute. Pretty sad. We can do better. Let's try this from the center. Battery resistor, switch diode, resistor, inductor, transistor, inductor, capacitor, fuse, speaker, diode, IC, switch, IC, IC, battery, diode, switch, diode, switch, switch, diode, diode, speaker, battery, speaker. 38 seconds. Nice. It's very luck-based, that particular run. Still, that's an achievement. 38 seconds. Can you beat 38? You probably can if you give it enough tries, but I could take some pride in that. So that's a record repository. That's pretty cool. I'd rather not disturb these things on this desk. Is there anything else to observe here? There's the whiteboard. Yeah, I think I have to go into Gray's office and snoop in order to pick up how to put the transistors into that circuit. Since the obvious combination is not correct. There's nothing over here, right? Yeah. So let's go back down. See, is there anything on this board here? Elements 79 is gold. Okay. Sure. Trivia night. Dude, let's go out for trivia. Such as, what is element number 79? He doesn't want me snooping in his office, obviously. Yeah, this office is not secured, which is okay. So let's go around here. Full power, Schrodinger's cat's alive. Unlock all the batteries. Nope, that's not what I'm looking for. Security videos. Key cards we already solved. Pretty taking a look in here. I'm really not seeing any clues as to how to solve that particular transistor puzzle. So I'll have to reattempt that during the day. Jack in the Bull. Fluffy whole wheat faces. Let's turn that on or off. Let's not leave that on. Is there anything else? There's nothing in here that suggests how to put together that circuit board. We've already read through that book. It was quite a good book. Let's go back to the daytime. Maybe Ryan could help us out, though I doubt it. I seriously doubt it. But you never know. Ah, I hit the wrong button. I meant to click over here, not over there. Let's try that again. Ryan, do you have anything to tell us? You have nothing to tell us.
Goodbye. Later.
Okay. Yeah, I think I've exhausted all the dialogue options in this game until further plot progresses or until further plot progressions occur.
I'd better get going.
Goodbye.
So I better take some care to I'm not sure. Not entirely sure how to progress. I think I just have to go into the lab and keep experimenting, which is disappointing. But I mean, how else can I learn stuff? I'm not gonna find any books here explaining stuff, right? There's just wafers in this cabinet. There's nothing on the computer to interact with. There's this book about manufacturing design. That's not what I'm looking for. Anything else? Nothing in this lab. Don't feel like going into the air ducts, and I'm surprised the game even suggests that opportunity to me.
The red must mean it's locked. I bet if I turn everything blue, it'll open.
Okay. Unlock the supply cabinet is a new objective. Huh. I mean, how hard could this game be, right? Apparently this is hard. My goodness. I guess lights out on a larger display is a little bit easier. I guess it's worth noting that throughout all this, diagonally adjacent squares don't count. I don't understand why that didn't just work. Okay. So now we have access to all the fun chemicals. Not that we need that. Wow. Says authorized personnel only. I'm really not supposed to be here, so let me head out. So, okay. Well, we did unlock the supply cabinet.
Check.
So that's good.
Can't check that off yet.
I'm not sure I understand the meaning of the list of book titles. There's definitely some books over there. Some books over here. There's books everywhere. Nico probably has good taste in books, though what do I know? Element 74, not 94. 94 was gold. I'm surprised that Victor and company don't ask me how I even got into the lab. So there's probably a resonant frequency that breaks this open.
I need to close the box first.
Or wait, no, I probably need to place something in there and then run it at the resonant frequency to do something. Oh man. I know I'm gonna get so busted for being in this lab. Well, we got access to the supply cabinet so we can access all the dangerous chemicals.
Something must be broken.
Repair the small Tesla coil in the lab.
Something must be broken.
Okay. What else is there here? Some tanks, which we stumbled upon earlier. Chemicals of various sorts. Switches, a clock, or some sort of meter. High voltage stuff. And then there's this part of the lab. Not interested in going in there at the moment. There's stuff I can click on. Apparently not. Can I observe this thing on the floor? Apparently not. I know I don't want to spend too long in the lab in any one session, so that's why I keep going in and out the door in the hope that the game won't, like, discover that I'm in the lab for me briefly being in there and then being out and then back in again. I'm concerned that there's, like, some time-based event based on me just sitting in the lab for too long. And I think that's just... if there is such an event, it's just to discourage me from lounging about in the lab, getting frustrated. If that's the case, then it's quite effective. So... repair the small Tesla coil in the lab. Oh, hey, look, a bag. A book. Yeah, I'm quite familiar with this Edison versus Tesla debate and how Edison went, like, electrifying animals or something. Well, that's weird. That's surprisingly clean based to other things in the lab. Okay, leave that to print. It's not the most elegant design in the world, but it's a design. Not sure what design I ought to be printing, because I don't really have a design to print. I seem to be missing quite a bit of information. I'm not sure how to progress without said information. Obviously, I cannot... I could lock myself in the lab and turn up the Tesla coil to full power. Not sure if that would kill me or if they would close the lab first and then eject me from the lab or something. That's dangerous stuff. What else is there? I mean, how do I repair this Tesla coil? Do I have parts with which to repair it? Capacitors aren't going to work on that coil. Oh, Tesla coil is a user's guide. We need the primary coil, the secondary coil, the toroid, and capacitors. Well, we certainly got capacitors.
Something must be broken.
You think? I mean, it's, I'm looking for something to. Yeah, I'm not sure what it is that could be broken about that small coil. I could ask the game for hints because that would help keep things moving and not have to deal with frustration. Though I still want to find some schematics somewhere. There's got to be some kind of schematic for me to follow. Scientists and researchers are the sorts of people who document what they're doing. And so it shouldn't be an impossible feat to discover that which I seek. I shouldn't have to go randomly clicking everything, and in fact, randomly clicking things probably should be ineffective. I do find it amazing, though, like that earlier encounter. They were just telling me stay out of the lab. They didn't even ask a question, how did the freaking heck did you manage to get into the lab? Like, Gray's got to be super pissed that I made it in here at all. Because he's the head of security, and the fact that just anybody can get into the lab is a huge security problem. Now, was there not a Tesla coil on the main floor here? No, I'm thinking of the secondary lab, the high voltage lab here. So, the obvious idea did not work. Which leaves me questioning, what do I need to do for this to work? I mean, there's nothing that suggests right side up or upside down for any one of these. And while it's tempting to orient them all in the same fashion and say therefore they must all be correctly oriented, that isn't necessarily true. Like, to me this looks a-okay, but but Nancy's not, I don't know. Replace the capacitors in the Tesla coil. Is that not what I'm doing? How is this not the correct way to orient them? Or if it is, can't I just slide this back in here? Oh, wait a minute. This part. Is this something I could be missing? Huh, what is this here? Can't do that. egg sure as heck doesn't go there. You can maybe stick a wafer into there. I'm not sure why I even want to replace the capacitors in this coil. It seems like a dangerous thing to do. And what benefit would it gain me to even do that? Well, I should not play with the electronics up here, but I could still snoop in the booth here. There's really not a whole lot to see. Sure as heck I'm not going to touch that. Is there anybody I could call?
Yeah.
I don't know if we're buddies like that. I mean, I do know, and we're solve this case on the quick, please, because I do not want to write a billion-page paper, thank you.
Okay.
Do you know how to fix a musical Tesla coil?
Yes.
Really?
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I thought you said, should I let you get back to what you were doing?
Bye.
Hang it up.
Thanks. For nothing. Alright. Well, can I call you back? Just for the fun of it?
What's up?
I better get going.
See ya!
Alright, that was fun. Well, who else can we call?
Hi!
I'll let you go.
Later.
Alright, that's a bit noisy. Let me turn it back down a touch. What's up, Victor, my man? Looks so happy here.
I found the key card that opened the lab the night of Nico's murder.
You did?
In Ellie and Mason's office. I think maybe we should take this to the police.
Good instinct. But let's not do that yet. If they reopen the investigation now, it'll be months before anything gets resolved. And that's if they solve the case.
Okay. Okay. Good to know.
Talk to you later.
Well, that keeps things simple.
Hey there, Nancy Drew.
Bye.
Hey there, Deirdre Shannon. Or Deirdre Shannon. Wow, this battery keeps quite... Or this phone keeps quite the charge. It's impressive. Alright. I'm not going to engage that. Oh, so many high voltage warnings. Like, I don't know, if you put warnings on everything, does anything ever serve as a real warning? So, is there anything I can tell from this figure itself? It seems like a puzzle of some sort. If I invert that I get the sense that all these capacitors are upside down in this column if I do it that way. So I'm still curious. What's it going to take to reassemble this? Because the obvious approach is not working. All right, let's get a hint. According to the Tesla coil design book, they can't have the same color in any row or column. Look for a pattern. Okay, they cannot have the same color in any row or column. Take the one that has none working and put it in a straight line. Well, so it says I can't have the same color in any row or in any column, and to look for a pattern. Oh, hang on. I'm going to change this column. So apparently I had entirely the wrong idea. And I just did not read the book correctly. Maybe this will work.
All right.
There we go. So, yeah.
Check.
That's fixed.
Can't check that off yet.
Tesla coil itself is not repaired. Figure out the meaning of the list of book titles from Ellie's desk. I do need a hint. Correspond to the two rows of books in the lounge. Put the seven titles in the order they appear from top to bottom. In the lounge. Oh, the lounge. There's books in the lounge? Okay. I was not going to get that for a very long time. So let's go back to the lounge. So there's some books over here. Alright, so elephant's name, V equals IR, Tesla's good friend, Element 74, patent holder, Columbian Expo site, and Sagamore's fellow knight. Put the seven titles in the order they correspond to from top to bottom. Seven titles. I see far more than seven books there. There's no books over here other than that one. And I can't hold on to that book. I mean, maybe I do need to toggle those books in the bookshelf in a particular order. And that whole thing about put them in an order is maybe wrong. Maybe I just need to click the books in the right order. So can I reorder these books? Condemned Elephant's Name. I don't see an elephant's name anywhere here. Jeez. What's this book? Cannot even pick up the book. Okay, V equals IR is the resistance formula. these titles here. The Tuniston Divide, Topsy the Performer, The Search for Truth and Justice, The Crystal Skulls, Twice Told Tales, Reading Between the Lines, Something in Lancelot, maybe Guinevere in Lancelot, I'm not sure, Ohm's Law and Circuit Analysis, Optical Illusions, A Scandal in Colorado, A Fatal Experiment, Greenhouses, Sparks Alive, Short Stories for Tired Eyes, Illuminated Chicago, Marconi's Transatlantic Quest, The Collected Works of Tales, The Complete Stories, Complete Short Stories of Mark Twain, Mind Over Matter, Zoo something, can't even read that, Animals in Motion. Vehicles IR, we're just going to click this. Tesla's Good Friend. Tesla's Good Friend would be who? I want to say Marconi, but he's the radio patent inventor. Or the person holding the radio patent. Who would Tesla's friend be? Well, let's say that it's Marconi. No, that doesn't make sense. Marconi was not in the U.S. Tesla lived in the U.S. because he and Edison moved here. But let's say Mark Twain. Element 74. Do I see anything that resembles an element name somewhere here? Jeez. I should look that up. I don't see anything that even resembles an element name. Plus, it's difficult to read these book titles and author names and such. What are my other clues? Incorrect radio patent holder. 1983 Columbian Expo site. And Sagramoris Fellow Knight. Give me one second, I'm going to try to read this, just get really up close to my monitor. So I'm going to hit the washroom. I'll be back in a minute. I'd mute my mic if I could, so you have to forgive me for the lack of muting it. Actually, let me go grab a little bit of food here, just so I can have something to consume while I'm thinking. I tend to do better when I'm eating anyhow, or at least when I'm not fixating on just hunger. You guys have solved this already by now, right? I suppose you want me to flash the clues again. Some good books. The Condemned Elephant's Name, The Potential Difference or Voltage Equation, Tesla's Good Friend, Element 74, Incorrect Radio Patent Holder, 1893 Columbian Expedition Site, or Expo Site, not Expedition, Expo. Sagramore's fellow knight is Lancelot. Let me just randomly click all the books. Does this book sell or solve everything? I wonder. Oh, who's his friend here? Charles Batchelor. What was the expo site? You would think that that would be in here, right? So who was the patent owner for the radio? I thought that was Marconi. Oh, it is Marconi. Oh, Mark Twain was his friend. What was the expo site? They were saying 1894, right? What are my clues? 1893 Columbian expo site. So the patent holder is Marconi, which was later reversed to Tesla. Sagamore's fellow knight is Lancelot. This is the potential difference or voltage equation V equals IR. Tesla's good friend is Mark Twain. Condemned elephant's name is I don't know. Element 74. Let's go look up element 74. I mean, it's right over here, right? 74 is tungsten. Okay, so that's a light bulb. So, what's the condemned elephant's name? Rick, if I know. There's no more message boards down here. No clues of note over here, right? Like, you can't even see the book titles there. Can't see any of those book titles, so the game's telling you don't worry about it. Still, Ellie, could you have given us better clues, please? I want to snoop around Ellie's desk again. Just because this puzzle is super hard, and a diversion or a distraction would be much appreciated. So, we're going to go back to Ellie's desk. I'm not sure why Ellie's not there. Oh, hang on. Some of these books are illuminated. Am I free to move these about? No. But this eliminates the entire top row of books. Still, how am I to make anything of this? Condemned elephant's name. I mean, maybe I'll find that in 1893 expo site. I could figure that out. In Columbia. Let's go back to the Mark Twain book here, or the Tesla book here. 1893, right? 1893 Columbian Expo site. I don't know. There's a patent there. Yeah, I don't see it here at all. But somewhere in Columbia. A reciprocating engine. Huh. Whatever, let's take a look. I guess part of the reason Gray is not grilling me on being in the lab, in hindsight, it was pretty silly to be operating the coil under this circumstance. Part of the reason Gray didn't, like, ruin me for being there is because he doesn't know if I'm allowed to be there or not.
Glad you made it through that lock-in. That could have been real, real bad.
Made it through that lock-in. Oh, being locked in the photolithography lab. Wow.
Are you happy at this job? Of course. Victor seems to think your heart's no longer in your work. Is there any truth to that? Much as I'd like to say no, all my life I was the brainy one. At home, at school, on the bus, in the library, in the corner store. I know that feeling. Kids used to call me Watson. Watson? That little brat, Susie Watkins, started calling me elementary, my dear Watson.
Aww.
Because I made the mistake of correcting Miss Hines in front of the class one time.
Way to go.
But that was a mouthful. Became Watson after a month or so. Shouldn't have called her a brat. I take it back. What happened back there in the lab? I don't know. You're lucky you got out. Really lucky. Is this your card? Nope.
Oh.
Mason said it isn't his either.
Huh.
Then it must just be an extra.
Okay.
Why were you spending time with Mason? I thought you two didn't get along. We have to meet up to coordinate experiments once in a while. You and Mason are working on a project together. Something secret. You're wrong.
I don't know. Am I wrong? That's really weird.
Then why spend so much time together? We have a lot to coordinate right now. After Nico died, you left for a while.
Uh-huh.
That's true. Where did you go? Home. You mean back to where you grew up? Of course. I wouldn't call Colorado home.
Okay.
Why not? Between you and me, I'm looking to get out of here as soon as possible.
Okay.
Why? Even if what happened to Nico never happened, Colorado never welcomed me with open arms.
Huh. It's unfortunate that you feel that way.
Are you sure you don't have another reason for wanting to leave? Yes, I'm sure. When you left, I understand you took all of your work with you. It's my work.
Yes.
I need to keep it safe.
That makes sense.
Keep it safe? From whom? I just meant in general.
Oh, okay.
What made you decide to come back? The police.
Wow.
Did they force you to come back? They were persuasive. I don't know if they were going to force me back, and I really didn't want to find out.
Ooh, okay. That doesn't make any sense at all, but sure.
And Mason were smuggling work out. Don't use that tone. You have to understand, Mason and I put our lives into that work.
Yeah.
Nico wanted to give it away. That I can live with. Victor wants to sell it. If anyone is going to sell my work, it's going to be me.
Okay. That's fine. I mean, it's not my position to judge any of that.
This card I found, according to the record, it's the one that opened the lab the night Nico died. What do you mean? It's in the log. That was just a glitch. The video shows just one person entering the lab.
Oh, okay.
If you don't like the work, why are you still here? I don't know. Growing up, everyone had these high expectations that I'd go out and make something big of myself. What no one knew was, much as my mind loved the inside of a book, my heart loved nothing more than being with my family.
Hmm.
Especially my cousin Rachel.
Oh, that's cool.
My grandma used to say the two of us put a little extra spin on the world. Rachel was my best friend. And I'd give all I've got to go back to those days. But I was told to go and fulfill my potential. And I did. You could always just go back home. Funny. Everyone always says the opposite. We weren't rich, and school wasn't cheap. I took out some big loans that my gram put up the farm for. Can't
can't make the money I need back home in the sticks.
Oh.
Yeah.
All bad. I get to do my part in making the world a better place. That's a happy thought I can take to my pillow each night.
Well, that's fortunate.
Can you walk me through what happened the night Nico died?
This isn't something I should talk to you about.
Okay.
I know, but my boss would really like to know.
Look, it was a hard night for me. I'd like to keep it in my rear view.
Okay, fair enough.
According to the police report, Nico had been dead for 30 minutes before you called 911. What happened?
I tried, but the phones were out.
Oh, okay.
What about your cell phone?
I must have left it at home that night.
Okay, fair enough.
I'll let you go. Goodbye, Nancy.
Alright, thanks for your help. Ish. Is there anything worth noting around here? It's an interesting keyboard there. All right.
Still have to do that. Still have to do that. Haven't done that.
Right, extra data showing in the video. Oh, figure out why Mason was in the lab. Why Mason was in the lab after hours. I forget. He was working on some project of some sort or another. That was his motivation for being in the lab after hours. It's interesting that Ellie did finally show back up again. Let's see, is there anything worth talking with Gray about? I don't think so. We've already spoken with Gray on a number of occasions, and even more frequently raided his office, so...
So you got something better to do?
I'd better get going.
Bye.
Yeah. Fair enough. So let's check out these books again. Put these books in order, it says. Condemned Elephant's Name. V equals IR. So which one of these is the condemned elephant's name? I want to say that some of these illuminated books on the bottom shelf are what I should be touching. Let me just randomly pick some books because I'm struggling with this. Like I see... Flame, Houses, Sparks, Marconi, Tales, this Mind Over Matter by Pensy. It just seems like that upper shelf is not very well illuminated at all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't see 7 books illuminated. And yet there are 7 clues. And one of those clues does have to do with the Lancelot book, which is up here, which is not illuminated, so I'm not sure that that's really a clue at all. I should just go back during the day. Okay. say hi to Ryan and to Mason. I know we've said hi to Ryan on a number of occasions, but wouldn't kill us to say hi again.
What's up?
Oh, nice.
I need to rebuild the missing part from the large Tesla coil. Can you help me out?
I think I've got the plans here. Yep. There you go.
Nice. Oh, that's going to be a delight.
Thanks.
Okay, cool.
Do you know how I can get the little Tesla coil in the lab to work?
The circuit board is shot. You seem like you know what's up. I bet you can make a new one yourself. You'll find everything you need in the photo lab.
Oh, well, thanks for the vote of confidence.
Bye. Later.
That sucks. Okay. Yeah, now that vote of confidence doesn't exactly help me. Well, let's say hi to Mason. Maybe he knows something about an elephant.
Hey.
What do you know about Victor?
Not much. He was here when I interviewed. Asked some tough questions.
Huh.
Are there in the world?
So, how many are there?
The answers to those questions are never important. It's how you grapple with the problem.
Yep, that's true.
A good problem is like a fight to the death with your own mind. Or other minds. But that's all I remember about Victor. He drops in now and again, brings snacks.
Snacks? What kind of snacks?
Other minds?
Nico wasn't the only one working on energy capture. It's not just about getting there anymore. It's about getting there first. We were going to get there first.
And now?
Now it's just me.
Oh. Well, in that case, we're screwed. I mean...
Ellie said this card wasn't hers.
That's fascinating. Tell me more facts about the card.
Okay.
Fine. It's the one that opened the lab the night Nico died.
That can't be right.
It's in the log.
That was just a glitch. The video shows just one person entering the lab.
Oh, okay.
I'll let you go.
Goodbye.
Well, as long as only one person entered the lab, there's nothing to worry about. All right. Well, let's use the schematic. I think I have to use Mason's computer to use the schematic. Like, I can't just go into the lab. There's not a place for me to punch in said schematic.
I need to connect all of the circuits.
Oh. Okay. How do I do that? Connect all of the circuits. Oh, I can rotate any part freely? Okay. Well, that seems pretty simple and straightforward, doesn't it? Kind of wish they could have given me something a little bit more challenging in that respect. Oops, this goes like that. Now I guess it just happens that I stumbled upon the correct corner first, which greatly simplifies my task, but... okay, so yeah, maybe I was too critical too quickly. Let's see. Probably goes like that. Probably this has to go downward. probably something like that. Alright, this is actually going to be modestly challenging, I think. And for that, I'm appreciative. I was thinking that this is going to be trivial. I'm glad it isn't. This is a sort of logic puzzle that does appeal to me. Like, I could connect that, but what's the point in that sort of connection? Could connect that, but again, there's too many loose ends here. I suppose this is a sort of refactor I can make to the circuit, where I take two closed ends and open them up to open more pathways. Nice. So this doesn't need to be fully connected. So, yeah.
Haven't done that.
Right, so we've got the design. Now we need to prepare a solution and etch it onto a wafer. Preparing a solution is also... could be non-trivial. Do I have to actually manufacture a solution myself, or is there etching solution in a bottle somewhere? Look at all that stuff. Okay. So this machine in the corner, this 3D printer printed my thing. Yep. No files in queue. Oh, that's right. I queued up that stupid block. Okay. That's funny. So, where do I read up about etching solution? Yeah, I've already got a wafer.
I've already got one.
So I don't need two wafers because I've already got one. However, I do not have etching solution. It appears I don't have instructions on how to manufacture etching solution. Solution tank, the image tray, the tray for blank wafers, and the start button. There's all kinds of buttons everywhere. I think I might need to chat with Ryan again to get some help with the etcher. So, am I here during the day or during the night? This must be daytime. Yeah, this obviously looks like daytime. funny that Ryan doesn't ask me, what the heck are you doing? And just satisfies my healthy scientific curiosity.
Bye. Bye.
Which actually is not so healthy. So, yeah, let me get back onto Mason's computer to produce another 3D part. There we go. Yeah, for sure, having food helped me a little bit there. At least I like to think it did. Because it seems we're back on a roll again. Let's go back over to Mason's office and see. First of all, is Ellie here? I'm curious.
Oh, Nancy? What's up?
Bye.
Goodbye, Nancy.
Goodbye. Alright. Component design.
I need to rebuild Ryan's part.
Alright. Well, thank goodness this... Wait. Does it matter which way this is oriented? That's not it. Circuit design. Oh, okay. So as long as I can produce something that resembles this... Oh, okay, these are... Each one of these shows all four layers. So we got, let's try layer one first. Like that. Because I think layer one's going to be the hardest to figure out. Well, let's just start with a single edge of this, right? And that's it for this edge. And I could spin this. Good gravy. This is confusing. So there's our original perspective. So if I take this and turn it counterclockwise, I end up with this. These also must be turning it counterclockwise, like that. So I've turned that once, I get this, which looks accurate. Turn that twice, I get this, which says that layer one needs at least these two. Layer two needs something here. Layer three and four have something there. As well as building, not that way. It's building this way? Yeah. And then one over here. If I rotate this again, no additional clues here. So I just... Okay, now this is a big open space down here, right? Really depends how you interpret this top diagram. Well, let's just try building everything all at once. Just ill-advised, it's not very systematic. But, yeah, what can you do? Let's see, what have we got here? Not there. How about, no? This one? No. Here? Yeah, I think this looks... What diagram was I looking at? And then here. This is very Escher-esque. 1, 2, 3. Something doesn't quite look right there. Let's back up a bit. So this is what I was trying to match. That's tricky. Something's missing over here. If I spin that again. Oh, this block is on the wrong layer. It should be up here. That's what was confusing me. And then back here, there should be a block. Spin this again. We're missing. Are we missing a block in the middle of this? I don't think so. I think we're fine from that perspective. Let's go back here. Sign 1, layer 2 is missing a block. Not there. Here. Okay, so got our staircase on this face of the blocks. Let's rotate that again. Does this look correct? I suppose it does. Looks fine. 1 more. Does this match up? That looks correct. Not missing any blocks as far as I can tell. And then perspective 4 also looks correct. Okay, we added that to the 3D printer queue. Not sure if I'll be noticed for doing that here. That's okay. I still have no idea who that elephant is. I can't get access to the machine lab with Ryan absent. So I question what Ryan does in there all day, because, like, I don't see anything getting built, but what do I know? Maybe she's just honing her mechanical skill. We haven't spoken, although we haven't had much to say.
Yeah, what?
I'll let you go.
Bye.
Man, you seem cheerful. I think I've overstayed my welcome in that office. So let's go back during the day. I can't exactly go into the lab with the head of security right there. That would be unwise. Even if the game lets me do it, I'm not sure that it does. It just feels wrong to even attempt that. All right, where's the 3D printer? Here it is. Oops, not there. Print. Okay, start printing that. Wow, that is one fancy looking machine. I know I didn't comment on that earlier, but I mean, since when has science been so colorful? Okay, close this box. Yeah, but only when I'm in that perspective. Apparently, I can't close it from other perspectives. And I can toggle these knobs. But to no avail there. Check that out. Etching solutions. Extremely caustic. Do not over or under mix solutions. Incorrect amounts are deadly. Not to be doubled, tripled, or in any way altered. Seriously? Why can't I double or triple measurements? That seems a bit crazy. Also, I don't like the noise that I'm hearing there, so let me read the book when I'm not going to hear that noise. So, a wafer type. Oh, there's six type of wafers. There's a PT wafer, a silicon wafer, a gold wafer, a silver wafer, nickel, and aluminum. Oh, PT must be platinum. So for a platinum wafer, use hydrofluoric and nitric acid. In a 2-to-12 ratio. For silicon, use hydrofluoric, nitric, and water, 3-to-1-to-4. For gold, use potassium iodide in water, 2-to-12. For silver, use nitric and water. For nickel, use hydrofluoric and nitric. For aluminum, use sodium hydroxide in water. Okay. Mix the solution in the mixing beaker. Not oh my gosh. Would anybody really mix? I mean, seriously? Okay, base compositions. Nitric acid is nitrogen dioxide and water. Sodium hydroxide is sodium and hydrogen oxide. Oh, you have to make up the chemicals that make the acids? That seems crazy. Carbonic acid did not etch. They're just showing you, like, when you add this to that, you get a chemical. So, you have nitric acid, and I really don't like that buzzing noise. I think it's meant to be disturbing, to discourage you from, I don't even know what. But we got a silicon wafer. And a silicon wafer says that we need hydrofluoric acid and nitric acid and water in a 3-to-1-to-4 ratio. What it doesn't say here, and what anybody should know, I think, is that you are to add the acid to the water and not vice versa. I remember it's really important to do it the right way. Otherwise, you could get acid splash. For example, if you're adding water to a very reactive acid, you really don't want to be doing that. In the same way that you don't want to be putting a catalyst into an acid or into a base solution. You don't want to be adding water to acid. You want to be adding small amounts of acid to water until you get the correct chemical combination. So 3-to-1-to-4, hydrofluoric is extremely strong acid. Nitric acid is not as strong. Yeah, you want to be careful with that stuff, man. Like, really careful. So we need 4 of water. Now, it doesn't tell me how much that I need. Just says 3-to-1-to-4. Now, measurements not to be doubled, tripled, or in any way altered. So, are there instructions as to how much chemical I need? I don't think it's going to tell me. Thankfully, the worst that happens from using the wrong solution is that the wafer is degraded, as opposed to, you know, toxic gases being emitted, which would be bad. Alright, so I feel like saving again. We're going to save, even though we're still in the lab, we're going to use the same save file. Because I have a suspicion that I'm not going to get this right first try. You say. So I want to be super careful. Let's see, can we talk with anybody while we're in the lab? Do the Hardy Boys know anything about practical skills.
Have you ever used a rapid prototyper?
You mean a 3D printer? That's an awful name. It doesn't even make sense, but yes, they're pretty cool.
Any advice on how to use one?
Sure. It's all about following the steps. You've got to make the design, send it to the machine, find the prototyper, and start the fabrication process. Then you wait. Patiently. That's just you.
I thought so. Alright. Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. They didn't tell me anything I didn't already know. Some practical advice about how to use the designer would have been cool. Alright. Maybe I need some guidance from Ryan about chemical mixing before I actually engage in said nonsense. So let's go bug Ryan. Okay, Ryan. Tell me about mixing chemicals. Tell me not to put the water into the acid. Or don't. Fine. I guess I'll wait overnight for the part to manufacture. I don't think Ellie's gonna tell me anything helpful, but, you know, since we're here... Or is it during the daytime that Mason's here? I forget. But let's stop by here, in case we haven't already.
Hey.
I'd better get going.
See you later.
Okay. So yeah, let's wait for the part to manufacture, insert it into the coil, and hope that things work. Honestly, I should not be going into the lab during the night because the head of security's here, so we'll wait till the next day. Where's our 3D printer? Seriously, where's our 3D printer? Where did it go? Oh, here it is.
Looks like I'll have to try it again.
Damn it! I thought I had it. That's unfortunate. Okay, looks like I'll have to try that again. More dials than I need. Okay. Is there anything I can do over here? Nope. There's some cool looking technology, but... Makes sense. So for mixed solutions only. Whoops. Oh, I get it. Okay. Solutions. 3 to 1 to 4 for hydrofluoric, nitric, and water. Okay. Hydrofluoric is going to be 3. Nitric is going to be 1. Water is going to be 4. This is nitric acid, HNO3, right? Oh my goodness, who labeled these bottles? Seriously. Let me get a closer look at this. The one, the white bottle in the center has got to be hydrofluoric HF, right? The hydrofluoric acid go? That stuff is far too strong. So I see sodium hydroxide. Something sulfate? H2SO4. That's sulfuric acid. Ki is potassium iodide. HNO3 is nitric acid. I don't see sulfuric acid, HF. Oh, I'm sorry, hydrofluoric acid. Yeah, I'm missing HF. HF is super dangerous. So, like, seriously, you should be wearing gloves before you deal with this stuff. Well, that's cool. So where's the chemical cabinet that contains our hydrofluoric acid? Oh, there it is. We found it. That was missing. Okay. I should seriously not even be holding that bottle without gloves on. Or I should be absolutely certain it's properly secured and that I won't drop it. Alright, that's back in place. Again, you should not be handling this stuff. That's really dangerous, depending on its molarity. Or molality, or however you choose to measure it. Alright, so we want to take water, because beaker's empty. We want nitric acid in the quantity of 1, right? Because we have a silicon wafer. So to produce nitric in a quantity of 1, pour 4 into here, pour 3 into there, pour that out. Okay, start over. I don't like the idea of leaving any chemicals in the tubes when I'm done, but apparently the game requires it. So let's pour 4 into here. Take this, pour 3, and then our nitric acid, take 4, pour 3 into here, take the 1, pour it into here, and then take this, and we're good. So that's our formula. I've got my circuit patterns. I guess I could go to the photolithography lab. So we apply the solution. We've got the wafer. We've got a circuit design. Do I have a circuit card or something I need to insert? The image tray. Image should be transferred to the image tray or will be... Okay, but where's my image? Like, here's my circuit design, but that's not an image. Where's my image? That's not it. Well, let's try this. Circuit design. Put our wafer in place and hit the go button. Wait for that to etch. Does that take half a day to etch? Really shouldn't. Oh, it does. Okay, that's cool. So we wait half a day for that to complete. Anything else to do here? Oh, I have to go back to Mason and resubmit that print job. So let's get that taken care of. Okay. Can't do that during the day, so I need to do that at night. Technically, it's not done yet. But I'm pretty confident that I built that circuit board correctly. Less confident in my ability to do the 3D printing, but I was pretty close. It would be nice to see the printed product and compare it to the design to see where I messed up. But no such luck. So, yeah, let's try this again. Is Ellie here, and does she have anything to say?
Goodbye. Bye.
Ellie has nothing to say. Okay. Wait, did I click anything? No, everything's still back in order. Alright, we gotta print one of these. So here's our schematic. Layer 4 is going to be something like that. Layer 3. Oh, does that go all the way up? Is this 4 high? Yes, it is. 1, 2, 3, 4. It extends that way. So far, so good. This hanging point on the end has a point hanging off of it, which extends this way. Extends like that, extends down here. I think that's as much information as I can extract from the first schematic. Let's rotate. Alright, this extends to across like that. And that point has a vertical beam. Right? That vertical beam builds out this way. Is there anything more to notice from there? I don't think so. Oh, other than this vertical beam doesn't necessarily go the entire height of the figure. All right, rotate again. Anything to note here? These two are connected like that. This is already connected. I think that's all I can note from this perspective. Let's rotate it once more. Anything to note here? I don't think so. Other than, like, is there something back there, maybe? Layer 1, does that have something back here somewhere? Back here. It looks like there's something back there. Okay, figure 1. This block. That block's definitely not there. So what am I looking at in figure four? Am I imagining something? Maybe there's something on layer two there. Where would that go? No. I think that looks right. It's just this space down here is not the same dimension as that space down there. This looks proportionately larger than that. But no, I think this is pretty good. I don't think I'm missing anything. So maybe it's time to give another shot at this. Yeah, that looks fine. Is there a gap back there? I think so. Like a gap back here would correspond to something over here. Yeah, no, that looks okay. Print. Make sure to click print instead of clear. All right, so that's night. Now we can't go into the lab at night, so let's go back to daytime. We're getting there. We are getting there. So let's go back to daytime and then go back into the lab. Now, just because I submitted the print job or the design does not mean it actually started to print yet. So I have to engage the printer itself. So let's do that. Printer's over here. Has not started printing yet. Let's print it. That'll take some time. Let's go back to the photolithography lab. Okay, did we get... Okay, we got a circuit. Is there anything more I have to do with this circuit after it's printed on the wafer? I don't need to like cut out the circuit out of the wafer. That would be too advanced. Okay, the large Tesla coils in the other room. Oh, make a new circuit board for the small Tesla coil. Large Tesla, small Tesla. Apparently this is the one that needed the new circuit. Oh, right. Right. Great.
Check. Still have to do that.
Right.
Still have to do that.
All right, what is on our task list? So now we have to figure out how many notes does this... Oh my goodness, I'm playing an entire symphony here. Yeah. Well, I hope you've got some good musical ideas. Okay. Should I say hi to Ryan again? It's always fun to say hi to Ryan. She's just a nice person. So now I got to figure out the music exercise. We can do that. Alright, second floor. Okay. What's up?
I'll let you go. Goodbye, Nancy.
Alright, let's check out Mason's office. Alright, well, we know where... Oh, okay, so apparently the higher register is the lowercase letters. Lower register is the uppercase letters, but... what symphony am I making? Seriously. Is there... Well, okay, I guess I don't have any clues there. Yeah, I don't have anything telling me what kind of song to make. Assuming I have to make a song, but I mean, what's the point of just using the musical coil just for music's sake? Okay, let's go back down, advance to the next day, then go into the lab. I did not think there was this much of the game remaining. I'm impressed. Daytime. So I can go retrieve the results of my printing. Okay, hopefully I printed it right this time. Okay, the printer's on the right though, not on the left. There we are. Ah!
Oops, guess I'll have to try again.
No! Okay. Well, that's disappointing. Is there anything more in here worth looking at? I don't think so. That's sad. Play any number of songs on that thing, but I'm not sure what song it wants me to play. Okay. Is there anything on, like, the tack board here? Mad scientist or genius? The only thing that's able to be looked at there. All right, Hardy Boys, help me out.
Hi.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Later.
Okay. How about you? Help me out, maybe.
Hey. I'd better get going.
Hang
on. Victor. What's up, my man, my dude, my Victor?
Nancy, hi.
Bye.
Talk to you later.
Okay. It'd be nice to know if I didn't have anything to tell people. Though you'd think I'd be able to infer that on my own. Unfortunately, the characters don't have much initiative of their own.
Bye.
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 So, it falls to me to know stuff. to say hi to Mason. I don't think Mason has anything to tell me that I don't already know.
Hey.
Bye.
See you later.
Of everybody, he seems like the most chill guy that I'm talking with. He doesn't really care about my presence or absence. Though he does grow accustomed to my presence. I don't know. Ryan's also pretty calm and collected in that regard. Everybody else is already quite frantic and so are understandably annoyed by my presence. Okay, so back to this puzzle. Condemned elephant's name, V equals IR, Tesla's good friend, element 74. I've already forgotten 74. No, it's tungsten. Patent holders Marconi, the 1993 Columbian Expo site. I have no idea. It's somewhere in Columbia. Sagramore's fellow knight. Condemned elephant's name. Well, well, well. I don't know. Let's say Topsy. It's the condemned elephant's name, even though there's no way that could be right. V equals IR. Ohm's law. Tesla's good friend is Mark Twain. Element 74 is tungsten, which is used to make light bulbs. I don't see in a book saying tungsten, so I'm going to guess the Sparks Alive book. A patent holder is Marconi. Um, 1893 Columbian Expo site. It's going to be in Columbia. Anybody see a book that says anything about Columbia? I'm going to say Colorado. Scandal in Colorado. Sagramore's fellow knight is Lancelot. Okay, nothing happened. Let's try this again. The elephant? I don't know, the book? I mean, how am I supposed to know? Ugh. Let's read through this one more time. Oh, there's the tungsten book. Okay. A condemned elephant. I mean, it's got to be Topsy, right? How could that not be condemned elephant? Ohm's law. Tesla's good friend is Mark Twain. Element 74 is tungsten. Patent holder is Marconi. Columbian Expo site. I am a bit stumped as to which of these could be the Columbian Expo site. I mean, the only one that mentions a location is a scandal in Colorado, but that's not the Columbia, that's Colorado. But okay. And then the Lancelot book. I am stumped. Well, I gave it a try. I really did. I need another hint. The Tesla book in the lounge, periodic table in the hall, the War of Currents book in the lab, Mason's whiteboard, and the book on Ellie's desk, Topsy, the Condemned Elephant, is in the War of Currents book. Okay. War of Currents book in the lab. Mason's whiteboard. And the book on Ellie's desk will help with the answers. I think at this point I'm close enough that I could figure this out just by guessing. So Topsy's the condemned elephant. Ohm's law is V equals IR. Tesla's good friend is Mark Twain. Element 74 is tungsten. Incorrect patent holder is Marconi. The only one I'm unclear about is the expo site. But by process of elimination, I'm eventually going to get this. Number 7 is Fellow Knight. There we go. Chicago must have been that expo site. Is that it? Collected a Necro Diary 2 and a notebook. Faraday Cage is starting to fail. Have sent a materials request to Victor. May need to refabricate the edge before winter. Ellie should be made aware of the issue, of course. As long as it's only the two of us using the coil, it should hold for a while longer. Reminder, call Victor to have him expedite the materials before something disastrous happens. Need photosensitive paint, Faraday materials, magnets, USB drives. USB drives, really? Okay, fine. Science Desk Tribune, fabricating stories about my work. Add to media blacklist. More research materials are missing today. Keep closer watch on Ellie.
What was Nico working on? Is this some sort of code?
Okay. So this might help answer the question about how to do the song on the keyboard. Wow. Yes, this is some sort of code, and a pretty spectacular one at that. So, I can't just play out all these notes. These are too many notes to be played. One thing worth noting is, like, this O-I-L for oil. Like, one of the things that's repeating in this game is, like, the word coil, C-O-I-L. But yeah, the rest of this, shoot, I don't know. This is some really advanced stuff, man. This has got to be one of those mist-like mysteries. 9267 14318. So what happens if I put these all in order? If I read these in order, sky, O-M-I-B-W, then 3 would be W-B-D-L-E, and then 4 would be C-F, I mean, this is not going to read. Unless, can I, like, reorganize these somehow? Oh, I can scratch out letters. Still, that's pretty special. 9627 14318 10, yeah, etc. I can't scratch out the ones on top, just the ones on bottom here. That's like the only thing I think should be scratched out. C-O-I-L, but...
Still have to do that.
See what's inside Nico's notebook. Oh, right, we still haven't read or played back his journal. So let's do that. All right, what's new in our developments here? Nico Diary 2. Shift in what?
The sudden calmness to my enemies as of late. As if they're planning something. Paranoia has always come creeping into the back reaches of my mind when I stretch myself too far. But I've not been overextended. Quite the opposite. Everything has been going smoothly with the energy project. This, I fear, isn't paranoia.
That doesn't even make sense. Interesting. Can we go back to entry one?
Friday. The hours have gone negative this week. The news of the announcement has gone far beyond what I wanted. I've lost control over it. And we're not ready. Gray's been helping me comb through all the unsuitable work. I've had to step up my own security. I can't be too careful now. The mood in the lab has been tense for a long time. But there has been a shift.
Haven't done that.
Okay. So... see, is there anything else to do?
That's done.
Cool.
Haven't done. Did that.
Repair the small Tesla coil.
Still have to do. Did that.
Explore the lab. Yep.
Haven't done that.
All right. So, we're down to 4 items on the to-do list. Repair the large Tesla coil. Figure out what the extra data showing on the video with Gray means. Manufacture the missing part for the Tesla coil and see what's in Nico's notebook. That said, this is running a bit long. I should probably take a break and come back to this. I made some really good progress. And yeah, hopefully we'll continue making excellent progress in the time ahead. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.